Hey everyone, Cooler Masters just dropped a new variant of his venerable Hyper212 CPU cooler. Enter the Hyper212 Halo Black. Sporting improvements such as simplified installation hardware, a new MF120 Halo 2 cooling fan with addressable RGB LED effects, as well as a refreshed aesthetic. Let's see if this CPU air cooler is any good. Now for those of you who are not in the know, the Hyper212 series of CPU coolers have been around for a long time, where the original 212 was first launched back in 2007, close to 16 years ago. Since then, Cooler Masters released variants of the Hyper212 to cater to new CPU releases that came along as the years went by, and fast forward till today, we have the latest iteration of the Hyper212. The Hyper212 Halo Black. First things first, it's packaging. The Hyper212 Halo Black comes in Cooler Master's trademark color palette. We're talking a predominantly purple box with splashes of cyan and pink for added visual appeal. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this CPU cooler. We'll run through these specs in depth later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALK Tech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest developments in the PC hardware world. Opening up the box, we see that Cooler Masters used a combination of cardboard dividers and foam to secure the Hyper212 Halo Black and its accompanying accessories. First up, we get the 120mm MF120 Halo 2 addressable RGB cooling fan right here. And this is accompanied by an instruction manual, as well as a warranty information leaflet. Moving over to this section here, we get a bag of accessories and mounting hardware. Now with the fan and accessories out of the way, we see that the cooling tower is nestled nicely into a foam support base so as to protect it from movement during shipping. With that, let's take a closer look at the fan that Cooler Masters included with the Hyper212 Halo Black. It's a 120mm MF120 Halo 2 offering that sports a 7-blade design with addressable RGB light effects. The fan sports a RPM range of between 650 to 2050 RPM, a CFM rating of 51.88, and utilizes rifle bearings. As you can see, it comes with a 4-pin PWM connector and a 3-pin addressable RGB connector, and on the frame, we get RGB diffuser rings like so, on both sides. As well as rubber dampeners on all four corners of the fan frame so as to help reduce unwanted vibrations. Onto the bag of accessories, let's see what we've got here. Now with all of that arranged nicely, we see that Cooler Master has improved the mounting hardware that comes shipped with the Hyper212 Halo Black as compared to its predecessors. The CPU cooler comes with support for an extensive range of processor platforms, from the latest AMD Ryzen 7000 series of processors on the AM5 platform to Intel's LGA 1700 socket for its 13th generation Raptor Lake offerings. Given that the LGA 1700 socket shares a similar cooling mounting hole layout as its predecessor sockets, the Hyper212 Halo Black also supports Intel's previous generation CPUs on sockets such as LGA 1200 for 11th and 10th gen CPUs, and so on. Mounting hardware aside, Cooler Masters also included a tube of MasterGel Pro thermal paste right here, as well as a pair of wire-type fan mounting brackets like so. Onto the aesthetics and construction of the main cooler assembly. being more of a mid-range CPU air cooler, the Hyper 212 Halo Black has a pretty slim cooling tower design, where it comes with a stack of 50 fins with an offset kind of arrangement that should improve airflow through the said fins. Over on the top of the cooling tower, we see that Cooler Masters included an aluminium top plate with some screen printed motifs featuring a minimalist rendition of the Cooler Master logo. The said top plate obscures the ends of the heat pipes that the cooler comes with and sure goes a long way in making the Hyper 212 Halo Black look premium. Moving over to the bottom of the cooling tower, we see that the Hyper 212 Halo Black features 4 direct contact heat pipes that are painted black so as to match the rest of the cooling tower's appearance. That said, the contact plate that comes into contact with the CPU's heat spreader looks to be pretty well finished as well. With that, here's a quick summary of some of the key specs for the Hyper 212 Halo Black. Do note that this cooler is also available in white and is appropriately called the Hyper 212 Halo White. Now, to do a quick test of the cooling prowess for this CPU cooler, I'll be installing it onto my AM4 test bench that is powered by an AMD Ryzen 5 5600 CPU that currently has the stock AMD Raid Stealth CPU cooler installed. I'll then run some benchmarks and compare the results of the Hyper 212 Halo Black's cooling performance to the stock AMD CPU cooler so as to see how much of an improvement in thermal performance we're going to get. Now, the installation process for this CPU cooler on the AM4 socket, or AM5 for that matter, seeing as both platforms share pretty much the same mounting mechanism for a CPU cooler, is pretty straightforward, where you've got to mount the appropriate mounting hardware onto the base of the Hyper 212 Halo Black first. Do note that if you're upgrading from an existing CPU cooler, you'll likely have to remove your motherboard from the case first, as the Hyper 212 Halo Black utilizes the stock mounting backplate that comes with your AM4 or AM5 motherboard. In this instance, with the stock AMD Rave Stealth CPU cooler that utilizes the said stock backplate, removing the AMD Rave Stealth will cause the backplate to fall off, making motherboard removal from your PC case a necessary step. Now, I've gone ahead to remove the old thermal paste from the CPU already, and after applying the included Master Gel Pro thermal paste that comes included with the Hyper 212 Halo Black, installing the cooling tower is just a simple matter of securing 4 Phillips head screws to the 4 posts of the stock AM4 cooler mounting backplate. Thereafter, simply attach the MF120 Halo 2 fan to the cooling tower with the included fan clips, like so. Once done, connect the PWM and addressable RGB connectors to the motherboard. And you're all good to go. And here we have it, the Hyper 212 Halo Black, all set up on the test bench. In terms of the RGB lighting effects of the MF120 Halo 2 fans, I personally quite like the fan's aesthetics, especially with the diffuser rings that add some character to the CPU cooler's overall appearance. And with that, here's a summary on the specs of the test bench that I'll be using to test the Hyper 212 Halo Black with. We've got AMD's Ryzen 5 5600 processor on a Gigabyte X570 Gaming X motherboard, 16GB of Kingston DDR4 3200 RAMs, and ASUS RX 580 4GB graphics card, as well as a 512GB Gigabyte NVMe SSD. Powering all this hardware is Cooler Master's V1000 Gold PSU, and I have all this kit mounted on an OEM open air test bench. Now, to put the Hyper 212 Halo Black through its paces. I'll be running Cinebench R23's multi-core test, followed by Prime 95 to stress the CPU. Thereafter, to simulate real-life usage conditions, I'll be playing a bit of Fortnite to see how the CPU cooler's thermal performance is going to be like. To monitor the CPU's temperature, I'll be using Hardware Info 64's temperature readouts. Finally, the ambient temperature of my surroundings was measured to be approximately 29 degrees Celsius. With that, let's get started. First up, we've got Cinebench R23's multi-core test, where after checking Hardware Info 64's logs over the entirety of the test, the Ryzen 5 5600 achieved an average CPU CCD1 temperature reading of 62.1 degrees Celsius, with a low of 51.5 degrees Celsius and a high of 63.8 degrees Celsius. On to Prime 95, we see that with the Hyper 212 Halo Black, the Ryzen 5 5600 gets an average CPU CCD1 temperature reading of around 62.9 degrees Celsius, a low of 52.5 degrees Celsius and a high of 71.5 degrees Celsius. Moving on to an actual gameplay test, while playing Fortnite with medium-ish graphics settings on the 1440p resolution, the Ryzen 5 5600 achieved an average CPU CCD1 temperature reading of around 48.6 degrees Celsius, a low of 42.8 degrees Celsius and a high of 60 degrees Celsius with the Hyper 212 Halo Black. And with that, here's a summary of the thermal performance of the Hyper 212 Halo Black against the stock AMD Wraith Stealth CPU cooler, where I did the same battery of tests on the stock AMD cooler before swapping it out for the Hyper 212. Unsurprisingly, the Hyper 212 Halo Black beats out the stock AMD Wraith Stealth CPU cooler by a mile in terms of thermal performance, where I even managed to get a higher score for the Cinebench R23 multi-core test while using the Hyper 212 Halo Black. This is due to the fact that the Ryzen 5 5600 was able to run at higher boost clocks due to the additional thermal overhead from using a better CPU cooler. In terms of idle temperatures, the Ryzen 5 5600 achieved an average CPU CCD1 temperature reading of around 34.3 degrees Celsius, with a low of 31.3 degrees Celsius and a high of 38.8 degrees Celsius with the Hyper 212 Halo Black. The stock AMD CPU cooler, on the other hand, yielded an average idle temperature of 40.4 degrees Celsius, a low of 35.3 degrees Celsius and a high of 56.3 degrees Celsius. A short mention about acoustics and fan noise. I didn't have a proper decibel meter with me to measure the noise from the fans, but even under load, the MF120 Halo 2 fan was pretty quiet. Settling instead for a noise meter app on my smartphone, where I positioned the phone 30 centimeters away from the Hyper 212's fan, I got a reading of 48 decibels when the fan increased in speed on the default fan curve, while the CPU was under heavy load running Cinebench R23's multi-core test. I also got a reading of 45 decibels when the PC was idle. For context, the baseline ambient noise of my surroundings was measured to be around 45 decibels as of the time of benchmarking. All in all, the Cooler Master Hyper 212 Halo Black is a pretty decent CPU air cooler that would work well with mid-range CPUs such as AMD's Ryzen 5 offerings or Intel's Core i5 lineup. It'll definitely be a big step up in terms of thermal performance over the stock AMD or Intel CPU cooler, where it also has a great looking aesthetic coupled with good build quality, and represents an evolution in the right direction over the previous generation of Hyper 212 air cooler offerings. As of end March 2023, the Hyper 212 Halo Black is available to purchase for a price of around $49 from e-commerce sites such as Amazon, which converts to roughly 66 Singapore dollars. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.